We're going to take a look at multiplying two-digit numbers. And we're going to focus in on a representation of that. So you'll recall in a CRA sequence of instruction, we begin by having students make sense out of abstract situations concretely, and then we use a representation that is a connection between that concrete understanding and the abstract way of thinking. So we're focused in on this portion today in this representation. When we deal with whole numbers, we use place value blocks a lot for our concrete, and for our representation, we are going to use a square that represents a flat or 100. We're going to use a line that represents a rod or 10. And we are going to use a smaller circle that's going to represent the unit or 1. So let's take a look at our first problem. We're going to go through two. And I'm going to show you two different ways to represent these with an area model. So if we want to multiply 23 times 12. With an area model, I'm going to have to set up a length and a width. And along one of those, I'm going to model 23. That's two tens, three ones. And along the other side, I'm going to model my 12, which is 1 10 and two ones. And now we can start the multiplication process. So I have a 10 here. I'm going to multiply 10 times 10 times 10 and then times 1, 1, and 1. When I multiply 10 times 10, that gives me 100. So I'm going to draw 100. And one of the things I want you to see right up front is the connection between the length here and the width here and what kind of shape that gives us. So we see that length and that width in the shape that we're drawing. Again, 10 times 10 as we move across is 100. And then we move into our ones. So 1 times 10 is 10. And again, notice that shape. It's long like this one as we go down. And it's skinny across the top because it was times 1. So that area model holds true for each of the individual pieces. So as we finish out that row, 10 times 10 is 100. 10 times 10 is 100. 10 times 1 is 10. 10 times 1 is 10. And 10 times 1 is 10. Now we finish multiplying the 12. We've got our two ones to deal with. So I have 1 times 10, and that is 10. 1 times 10 is 10. And then 1 times 1 is 1, 1, and 1 as we finish out that row. The last thing we have to do is multiply by this other one. So again, that's going to give us the same row as before because we're still multiplying by 1. So now I've done the multiplication. I've come up with my area model. And so now the question is, what's that worth? Well, I count up my pieces. I have 200s, and 200s are worth 200. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tens. 7 tens are worth 70. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ones, which are worth 6. When I add up those partial products, that's 276. And so that's one way to represent multiplication with an area model. And you can see how we would do this concretely with the actual place value blocks. This is the drawing that represents that. Let's take a look at a second problem. In this one, we are going to multiply 25 times 24. So just like before, I am going to set up my length and my width. And I like to draw these lines because it helps the students see the separation between the factors and the product that's in that rectangle. 25 is modeled with two tens and five ones. 24 is modeled with two tens and four ones. Extend that line a little bit. Now I can start the multiplication process. So 10 times 10 is 100. 10 times 10 is 100. 10 times 1 is 10. And I can finish out that row. Here we're going to multiply times 10 again. So that's going to give me 100, 100, and then tens. And now we have to handle our ones. So 1 times 10 is 10. 1 times 10 is 10, and then 1 times 1 is 1. So now we know each time we multiply by 1, we're going to get 2 tens and 5 ones. I can go ahead and fill out those rows. A lot of blocks, right? This is one of the important things as we move from the concrete to the representation. The drawings allow us to deal with bigger quantities, or I should say bigger digits. So when we have more pieces that we would actually physically need to manipulate, it's much more cumbersome to do that with place value blocks, and that's when the drawings really start to benefit students. So now how do I come up with the product? It's going to be the same way as before. I have 4 hundreds. That's worth 400. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 tens, which is worth 180. And I have 20 ones, which is worth 20. And when I add all those up, I get 600. So that's how we would model it with our place value blocks as a representation. There's a second representation that I want to show you. We're going to switch colors for this one. And the difference in this one is that instead of using the blocks, we're going to start to decompose with the actual digits. So up here, we had 2 tens and 5 ones. We've decomposed it based on its place value. So what I can do is actually write those values. 2 tens is 20 and 5 ones is 5. I'm going to do the same thing with 24. Decomposing it based on place value, that's 20 and 4. And we can create a representation of our area model. And we can compute a little bit more quickly. Now, this is 2 tens and 2 tens. Remember, tens times tens gives us hundreds, just like it did with our place value blocks. 10 times 10 gave us hundreds. Now, 2 times 2 is 4. So 2 tens times 2 tens would be 4 hundreds. Or 400. In this block, we would be multiplying 20 times 5. That's 10 times 1, ones. 10 times ones is tens. And so I have 5 times 2, that's 10 tens, or 100. Down here, we're going to multiply 4 times 20. So that's 1 times 10 is tens. And 4 times 2 is 8. So that's 8 tens, or 80. And 1 times 1 is 1s, and 4 times 2 is 20. And one of the things I want you to see right now is that as we do this multiplication with the digits, we are, instead of having the blocks, actually coming up with those partial products. So we had 4 hundreds blocks here. That's why we get 400 over here. Here we had 10 tens lined up. That connects us to this 100 over here. Our 8 tens and our 20. So we can see that explicit connection and that transition we're going to help students make from moving with a representation that's based on a place value blocks to moving with moving towards a representation that uses the digits. And again, if we added these digits, we'd see the 100 and the 80 added together would give me the 180, and we end up with this same set of partial products as down here. So this is one step closer as we transition students across this CRA sequence of instruction.